Hello, I'm Kent Weakley, and today I'm going to show you how to make this photo. Panning a photo, or panning the shot, is a term that is derived from the motion picture industry. It basically means a movie camera or a video camera that's on a tripod that pivots from left to right or right to left. We can create a similar image with a still camera by panning, moving the camera when we create a shot. This will help us see action, speed, and motion. So what we're going to do is we're going to hold the camera under the lens, rest our index finger on the shutter release, bring the camera to our eye. We're going to use the eyebrow and the rest on the camera as stability for this. I'm tucking my elbows against my body, and I'm going to rotate my body from start to finish. In this case, I'm moving from left to right. And as I move across, as a subject moving across with me, I'm following it as closely as I can and shooting. The real challenge with making a panning shot is there's going to be a number of reject images, images that just don't have anything sharp and don't look good. That's because we're moving and our subject's moving and we're shooting at a low shutter speed. So those three things are going to combine to give us a little bit of an issue doing this. So we have to be willing to experiment and play and try over and over to get this shot. But when it works, it really works. So the concept is, the camera moves left to right or right to left. Anything that's not moving with the camera will be blurred because we're shooting at a slow shutter speed. The real trick lies in synchronizing the exact moment when the camera is moving exactly the same speed as the subject and then capturing that. That's the trick, but that's also where the fun lies, and that's where the great images come from. Now, to shoot in shutter priority mode or to shoot in manual mode, either one will work fine. If you have more questions about that, by the way, I have a great guide for shooting in manual mode. It's a flow chart that helps walk you through and answering specific questions, very simple, short amount of questions that will help you set up the right manual or shutter priority for your shot. If you're shooting in full manual mode, you're going to need to realize that you're going to have to adjust your aperture to match the light in order to get the shot. Now, if you shoot in shutter priority mode, you can adjust your shutter speed to what you think might work. The camera will adjust the aperture to match. Take your shot. If you're getting the motion you like, great. If everything's looking too blurred, then perhaps you need to speed up the shutter speed. If everything's looking relatively crisp and not blurred at all, or not blurred enough, you're going to need to slow down the shutter as well. Okay, let me show you how I edit this photo in Adobe Lightroom. Believe it or not, there's not much to do here. Most of the work is done in the camera. That's what makes this technique so fantastic. There's no trickery here. I'm not using any kind of blur settings or anything like that. This wasn't sent through Photoshop. This is all captured directly in the camera, which makes it really cool. So essentially, the only thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the histogram. I can see there's some dark areas that are getting a little dark. They're not a problem. There's some light areas in the main subject, the lady on the bicycle. And just to note too, this was shot at 1/15th of a second. And I'm moving from right to left as she's riding. You can see in the background here, there is a parked bicycle and the wheel of that bicycle is showing twice here, so you can see how much distance I panned in order to get this shot. The other thing that's kind of cool is there's usually a single point that's pretty sharp in this. It seems to be her hand and her watch right here. They're pretty crisp compared to everything. So for that little strip of time, her hand was really still and in the same spot. You can see her foot was moving a lot. The wheels were moving, obviously, as the spokes are all blurred. Anyway, this is just a fun way to create some really cool images. There's actually somebody walking by on the sidewalk here. Notice how it de-emphasizes the background to have the shot made this way and really makes you look at the subject. this person in the background is not conflicting at all. Had I just snapped a regular program mode shot at a faster shutter speed, I would see this person and it looks like they're looking to the right. So they would be kind of looking back and forth. It would be a little bit of a conflict. Okay, so back onto the editing. There's really nothing much here to do. I would add some vibrance to this, maybe a little bit of clarity, touch of saturation. Look at sharpening it just a touch. Again, we can zoom into the sharp area. You can see it's not 100% crisp. As a matter of fact, there's a little bit of chromatic aberration happening right here. So I'll go down to lens correction and we will click remove chromatic aberration. I'm going to enhance the green there a bit. That seemed to take care of it. All right, and then this subject's relatively centered, so I want to de-emphasize the outside corners and bring those in using the post-crop vignetting setting. And I'm moving that to the left just a bit. So there's the after. Here's the before, and there's the after. It's that simple. There's really nothing to it. Whenever you get a chance to capture as much as possible in the camera, that's always the best way to go. We want to do as little post-production to an image as possible, ideally. So there you have it. That's how you create a panning shot and you illustrate motion, action, or speed using a still camera. Now let me know if you've done this before or you plan on doing it. Leave me a comment below and send me your images. I'd love to take a look at them. Also, please like this video if you found it helpful and subscribe to my channel. You know, I'm trying to get as much information out to as many photographers as possible. After all, that's why I'm doing this. I really want to share photography with everyone. I want them to make the camera be an instrument for their creation and not a source of frustration. The camera needs to drop away so that it just becomes a tool that we create with. And once you get to that point, it's incredibly fun and satisfying. So until next time, happy shooting.